that you are ninja?
Well, we're making a ninja film. You know, says it in the title, ninja.
Around the 20th century, basically ninjas were almost, became really legends. We had an opportunity to bring the genre into the 21st century. There's a martial arts school that teaches the old ways of the ninja in a modern way. That school has a box.
A sacred box called the Yoroibitsu.
The Yoroibitsu. It is the final resting place for the weapons of ninja warriors through the ages. They were created for one purpose only. Sudden and violent death.
And the successor to the school will get the Yoroibitsu. And there's two feuding students at the school.
Asazuka!
Hai!
Marude Torada. Chikarazyok, Anteikangari, Ketsudanryokugar. Kishi!
Hai!
Minashigoto shite koko e kita. Hitofuki no kaze ga ookina arash tonaru you ni. Tayumanu keiko o tsuzuke, migoto na waza to chikara o tsuketa.
Asazuka, in a fit of rage, tries to kill Casey.
Kind of loses his cool because of some jealousy.
He's banished from the school.
Even though he was the best guy, but because of his heart was dark, he couldn't make it.
Being expelled from the dojo, he becomes the dark side of the ninja.
And then 3 years later, he turns up and he wants the Yoroibitsu.
He wants to feel that he is legit.
We are told to take this box to New York for safekeeping. And the film completely turns on its head and goes to New York and becomes even more action-packed.
It was very important for me to make a movie where the hero will be like in constant danger and in constant run.
Masazuka can't control himself and he can't stop to see himself becoming a villain.
Please, whatever you want, I'll give it to you.
If I choose only one scene, I would like to say the scene Masazuka tortures Namiko in his hideout.
Masazuka,
listen to me. I want
the Yoroibitsu.
Oh, fine.
I think we're very, very lucky to have Ihara.
I heard about him. I saw him also in letters from Iwo Jima. He's basically a Japanese star. And
he brings good tension to the set.
First time we fought together was on top of the police station rooftop. And I remember thinking, God, man, this guy's wiping the floor with me here. I'm gonna have to pick it up a bit.
Scott Adkins and I have a long history. This was our fourth movie together.
Scott has been very kind and friendly. I was very lucky to be able to have Scott as a Namiko's partner.
He's really great to work with. I mean,
It's really great to look at.
The actor Scott Adkins has the very rare ingredients of a good actor and a good martial art fighter.
I thought I got lucky. You know, his abilities were so good.
In Ninja, it was really tailored upon his abilities, and it was a pleasure working with him.
That's quite a story, Casey. So you're saying that this Masazuka guy, who nobody's seen or heard of, sent the ring to retrieve a box?
The Yoroi Bitsu.
Right. So where is it?
I can't tell you that.
Why not?
Casey is quite naive at the start of the film. He's an incredible martial artist, but he's not used to being in real fights. But when he gets into a situation, you know, he reacts and he fights people, and he's not thinking about it because he's so highly trained. More just a normal guy that finds himself in extraordinary situations.